Hello everybody, welcome to the most in-depth OBS tutorial I have ever given on this channel ever. OBS is an open source recording software that can screen record and stream to different services online. So we have three main things that we're going to be going over today: recording, streaming, and a virtual camera without having to do any type of plugin download or anything like that. I am using a Mac for this tutorial. If you guys are using Linux or a PC, everything should be about the same. The only thing that you guys need for this tutorial is a web browser, which does come on essentially every single computer. So hit the link in the description, which will bring you to our OBS download. Again, I'm using a Mac for this tutorial, so I'm going to go download the Apple Silicon download installer, and then you'll click on the different operating systems depending on what you have. You guys can put this save file anywhere. I'm going to put it on my desktop. Then I'm going to double click on this save file. For Windows, you guys are going to have an exe install setup type of deal. You're going to go through that and walk through the process the same as what we're going to be doing right here, I do believe. I just dragged OBS into the application folder. Now what I'm going to do is go into my launchpad and find OBS. After going into the launchpad and clicking on OBS, a pop-up window will appear asking you to review the app permissions. This is going to allow OBS to actually do the screen recording, the streaming, understanding your microphone, your camera, that type of thing. I've already given it access to all of these things. I literally spent 20 minutes trying to find all of the cache files because I deleted OBS, reinstalled OBS, and then it remembered everything that I had already set up. So it's kind of hard to do a tutorial when it's already set up. So anyway, I've already given access to all of these things. Go ahead and do it and then hit continue. You will now be met with a new scene and an auto configuration wizard. This is a newer thing from OBS. It's been around for probably 3 or 4 years, so not that new. But in the olden days of pure streaming content that I created, it did not have an auto configuration wizard. So you're going to select whatever you're actually going to be using this for. You can optimize it just for recording or optimize it for streaming. You're going to set your base canvas resolution to what you are wanting to capture. So I'm wanting to capture this weird not 16:9 aspect ratio. You guys are probably going to have a 1920x1080 monitor. Then you guys are going to be choosing the frame rate at which you are wanting to record. Now, most gaming situations on YouTube nowadays are 60 FPS. They're actually 59.94. However, if your computer, if it just doesn't have a good graphics card, a good CPU, not enough RAM, you guys may want to do 30 FPS. The next thing you will do is connect your streaming service. Now, if you guys use Twitch, you guys will find a stream key when you are streaming or when you're setting up for your stream. You can either use a stream key or you can actually connect your account. I do believe you can also just connect your account on YouTube as well. Yeah, you can just connect your account to it and then it will pull the stream key from there. After connecting your account, you guys can hit next. Now it's going to be running a bandwidth test on your computer to decide the different bit rates that you can be streaming at, the audio quality, that type of thing. Once the results come up, it will show you your bit rate, your streaming encoder. You're going to hit apply settings. And now we are met with our first look at what OBS looks like. So at first glance, OBS can look very intimidating. I'm going to close this whole YouTube chat thing. This is going to be showing your actual chat that flows in while you are streaming, which is very cool that OBS has added this, because it used to be just like plugins that's how you could watch your chat from OBS. But it's very cool. You can always go back if you close a window accidentally. We'll walk through how to open that up. It's a dockable window, so you can just open up that dock once again. But this is the actual look of OBS. Each window is movable, so you can like move around what you want to be looking at and what you don't want to be looking at. I normally have my windows about set up like this. Let's do a super quick rundown of each window. First, we have our scenes. Our scenes you can think is the most broad. You'll put your sources inside of your scenes. So like you can have a scene for gaming, you can have a scene for chatting with your audience. You can have a scene for showing a certain game and you can have another scene for showing another game. These scenes can have hotkeys connected to them to where you can hit just a certain button on your computer and a transition will show up and it'll transition you into all of the other scenes that you have. You already have a scene open here. I'm going to right click on this and just call it scene one. I know it already said scene. I'm just gonna add one there in case we need to add multiple scenes. I know which scene is which. Then we have our sources. Our sources are things like our camera, our microphone, our screen. These sources are just the things that are visible and audible to your audience as they're watching your stream or your recording. The next thing is your audio mixer. This is where you can see all of your audio sources during a stream or a recording. You can also add certain effects, which we will go over. Then you also have your scene transition. You can change your scene transition. I actually have a custom stinger transition that is completely free to you guys up in this corner right now. It is a tutorial and it also comes with a free download as well. You guys can set that up afterwards, but just letting you know that it's there. We do have our preview right here as to what we will be streaming slash seeing. So when we add our sources, we will see it pop up here. And then the last window is the control window. This is going to be where you're going to set everything up, where you're going to start your recording, start your stream, or start your virtual camera, the three things that we talked about in the beginning. So let's go through and start setting up our first scene. In scene one, we're going to add a source. In this case, I'm going to add my screen. For my Mac users, you guys have a Mac OS screen capture that you can click on and choose the screen that you want to show. If you guys are on Windows, 1 second, I am going to show you how to do this. On Windows, you guys will see a display capture or a window capture. A display capture just allows you to look at a certain display, so like a built-in retina type of deal. That is, you know, one monitor that's on my laptop right now, but you guys may have a drop down of multiple, or you guys will have, 1 second, add window capture. You guys can actually capture a certain window within your computer. So if you have a certain game open that you just want your audience to see, you guys can choose that window and then you don't have to worry about them looking at your desktop, other stuff like that. For my scene though, I won't need either one of these. So I'm going to remove them both and then add our Mac screen OS. So I'm going to hit this little plus icon here and then hit Mac screen capture. You can call it whatever you want. It's not something that I just talked about a second ago with the other displays. We're going to call this display one. You also, I do believe on Windows, have the ability to show your cursor as well. I know you have it on Mac, so you can actually hit this if you don't want to show your cursor and you want a clean like recording of whatever you're trying to record. You don't want to accidentally see your cursor. For some of you like me, you guys will already have a mic aux here and it should be pulling from your microphone that you have connected to your computer. If you guys don't see that, you can go and add your source to it by audio input capture and call it like mic one and then hit okay and then choose your device that it wants to pull from. One thing I do want to say about the displays that I don't want to miss is that you can actually select on the display and actually move it around inside of your canvas here. If you don't hold down shift, it'll keep its aspect ratio. If you hold down shift, you can actually smush it, squeeze it, you know, do whatever you want on however you need to fit your source inside of your stream. If you hold down alt and then you were to drag, you can actually crop things in and out. This is extremely helpful. Trust me, you're going to want to use this. If you hold down alt and if you're on a Mac, it's holding down option, you can actually add multiple displays to it and it works as a top-down layering, meaning that if you have two displays here, I'll just do this to show you real quick. So right now I have two different displays. I have one and then I have two. I have, you know, one behind the other one. So you can actually layer them and whatever one is on top is the one that will be seen. And then underneath it, it will not be seen. Just thought that for beginners who are learning OBS, that's a pretty important step when adding things like overlays and graphics onto your stream. So now that we are done with our video, we have our one display and our one microphone set up. At this point, you could probably just start streaming if you truly wanted to. You have your microphone and you have your game, but I want to make sure that your audio sounds good. We're going to head over to our microphone in the audio mixer. Mic one equals mic one over here. I do have this mic aux already, and that's because that was just a default thing that happened when I opened up OBS. If you guys already had a microphone in there, I'm just going to delete this real quick. That way we just have one audio microphone here. If you guys didn't have that, add your source of your microphone and then follow the steps of what I'm about to do. To monitor and listen to your audio right now, to be able to test and make sure it sounds good, we're going to head into the three dots here next to the source, hit audio, advanced audio properties, and then audio monitoring. You can actually monitor inside of your headphones, just monitoring and muting the output to where it doesn't end up inside of your video where like the audio doubles up. However, I just turn this on while I'm listening to it to make sure it sounds good. And then I'll turn it back off because sometimes, who knows, it may get in there, it may not. You guys may accidentally hit the wrong one. It's just always a good practice to turn your audio monitoring off after you're finished monitoring it. Because I'm not wearing headphones at the moment, mine actually plays through my speakers, which is not good. So be sure to put some headphones in and then listen to it. If you guys are like, ooh, that doesn't sound good at all. Well, let's walk through that. So you can leave your monitor on. I know mine's off, but you can leave yours on and go into filters by hitting the three dots once again. This is a blank canvas for you to add filters to your microphone. OBS actually has a decent amount of really good just effects that you can add on different things. So we're going to start by adding a hard limiter to our microphone. A hard limiter basically keeps your microphone from becoming distorted on stream. It almost saves your listeners' ears if you accidentally have some audio problem or anything like that. A little audio lesson real quick. You can see down here on the microphone, it goes from negative 60 to zero, and it has from about negative 8 to zero as in the red. What this means is essentially when an audio track hits zero, it becomes distorted. And so you never want your audio on stream to ever hit zero. So having a limiter on your mic actually protects your listeners' ears from ever hitting zero. However low you make it is how it is like the ceiling as to how loud your mic can go. It's honestly good to add this effect after you've done all of your other editing, just to ensure that your listeners are never going to listen to distorted audio, even after you've finished adding your gains, you know, your equalizers and your noise gates and stuff like that. However, I'm just showing you limiter is probably one of the best ones. And if you're just going to add one, add that one. In OBS, we like to keep our microphone from anywhere from negative 20 to negative 10. I know it's in the yellow. However, your audience listens to voices on TV shows and other things at negative 6 to negative 12. And then the background music and sound effects normally happen anywhere from negative 24 to negative 12. So looking at the waveform right here on the microphone, you can see that mine, when I'm talking, just normally hits around negative 20. It's normally holding around that. So I am going to add a little bit of gain here. Kind of like our video, the audio filters work in a top-down format. So if I add a gain and then I move the gain up, it's going to first gain my microphone, and then it's going to pull that down and limit it to negative 3.5 decibels. So now you can see that when I am talking, my voice normally is holding it around negative 15 to negative 10. That's around what we're wanting. You can also see that when I'm not talking, you can see that my microphone is actually still picking up noise. So just listen. The noise level reaches just about under 40. So the next thing that we're going to add is a noise gate. So if you click on the plus icon here and you go down to noise gate, they do have a noise suppression, which sometimes doesn't necessarily work too well, but the goal of it is it'll actually pull out the noise from your microphone. So looking inside of the noise gate, you can see that it actually added negative 38 and negative 28 as the two options here for the closed threshold and the open threshold. This means that when I speak into the computer, it's going to open up the microphone when it hits negative 28. And then when I'm done speaking, the audio is going to go back down. And when it hits negative 38, it's going to cut it off completely. So I have to be louder than negative 28 decibels. Again, it's best to put that above the limiter. That way at the very end, the limiter can take it and be like, all right, everything that you did can't go past negative 3.5. I would mess around with these certain settings. I can make a video on adding all of the filters that we want to add to our microphone to make our microphone sound the best. However, I'm going to leave it at this because these are like the three main ones that you're going to want before you hit the start streaming button. Now we're actually going to head to our settings and go through our video settings and our audio settings to make sure that we are completely ready to go when streaming on YouTube or Twitch. To do this, you're going to head down to the controls panel, hit on settings, and then first go into video. Our base canvas resolution is the entirety of what we're looking at when we are sourcing our image to go on YouTube. And then our output scaled resolution is actually going to be what our audience sees in the recording or on YouTube. I'm going to set this to 1920 by 1080. That way you guys can see what I'm talking about. The aspect ratio is 16 by 9. The output scale is still going to be 16 by 9. And you can see that we can downscale our output to go to different places. Normally, you're going to leave it 1920 by 1080, 1920 by 1080. Here you can see is the FPS that we talked about earlier. OBS actually does have 5994. It just didn't say it in the audio configuration wizard. I like 5994 because it matches everything that I shoot. I shoot my camera at 5994 and I record my gameplay at 5994. Just remember that if you guys start streaming at 5994 and you guys are streaming at some super high resolution, you're going to need a good computer and good bandwidth on your internet. Next, we're going to go into audio. Make sure that your sample rate is 48 and the channel is stereo. Earlier when I talked about how the microphone just automatically popped up, this is what I was talking about in the global audio devices. You can actually disable this if you want to, where you actually have to add in your microphone inside of the sources. Other than that, I believe that we will leave everything the same in here. Next, we're going to go to our output. Now, I like to change my output mode to advanced. That way I know all of the settings that I'm setting up when streaming. Right now, your bitrate is super, super, super low. It's set up to 2,500 kilobytes per second. We need to change this. Now, you did see that in the simple, it did say that ours was 10,000 kilobytes. That was from our auto configuration wizard. That's what they think that we are okay to do. However, Twitch has a limit, I believe, of 6,000 kilobytes per second. And then YouTube, I don't think, has any type of limitation. So we're going to measure based off of the bandwidth of our computer and our internet. I would say that for you guys, you should be doing anywhere from 4,000 to 8,000 kilobytes per second. If you guys have higher end internet, you guys can make it 8,000 to 10,000. However, this is the limit and where I would like, you know, to stay when streaming. That way my audience is able to view my content on mobile, on a computer, and also I'm not outputting just garbage to them like 2,500. If everything I said was just like over your head, put 4,500 to 6,000. The higher the number, the higher the quality. But the higher the quality, the harder it runs on your device and your internet. It may take a couple streaming tries, you know, just a little bit of testing to figure out what the exact one is that you guys are wanting. I'm now going to go over to the recording tab to just figure out where my recording path is. Right now it says it's going to users, Austin movies. I'm going to change this to like my desktop. Then I'm also going to change the recording format. I forgot to mention, if you guys are using OBS for recording, then this is a good thing to change. I'm also going to change the recording format to MP4. It does give you a full like warning as to why you shouldn't be doing MP4. It's just because if your computer were to shut down in the middle of a MP4 recording, it would not save anything. But if you have it as an MKV, it would save essentially to a certain degree the video that you recorded. However, it's much harder to edit MKV video in like Adobe Premiere Pro as opposed to MP4. I also have a very cool video on separating the audio tracks for your recording, meaning that you can separate your audio, your gameplay, your Discord, your music into different audio tracks, meaning that you have full customization on what is actually playing to your audience when you are recording. Another really cool feature that OBS has inside natively is actually starting a virtual camera. Virtual camera is essentially meaning that anything inside of your canvas, once you start your virtual camera, is now showing up as an option for you to click whenever you are choosing your camera. So if I were to go into Discord, you can actually choose your virtual camera and they can see what's on your screen. I know that in Discord, you can just share your screen, but in this case, you can like add different things or show them your setup for your stream. To end off this full tutorial of OBS, you guys can head to the Discord. If you guys have any troubles, me and the team would be more than happy to help you out with any problems that you come across. A couple troubleshooting things that I just wrote down here: ensure that your latest drivers are installed. If you guys don't know how to install your latest drivers, you guys can watch my video on how to speed up your computer. I'll leave that also right up at the top. Also, adjusting your settings for low-end PCs can prevent lag and dropped frames inside of your game. You just have to be thinking about, how beefy is my computer? Can I play my video game at full capability and record this slash stream this to other people? And if you can't, there's a couple things, you know, hardware-wise that you could upgrade. You could lower your settings inside of OBS or your game to ensure that your audience is seeing quality on the stream or the recording. Hopefully this was beneficial to you guys. I may have missed a couple things, and if I did, I'll leave some notes down underneath in the description or in the video itself. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.